Banquo and his son Fleance is having a conversation about how bright the moon has been shining, and about how Banquo has been having a hard time falling asleep. Macbeth enters the scene, along with a servant. Banquo tells Macbeth that the king must be feeling unusually generous lately. He delivers a diamond that Duncan had requested to be given to Macbeth in return for his wife being a
most kind hostess.
Banquo then tells Macbeth that he's been having dreams about the three witches that they have seen earlier on in the play. Banquo realizes that some of what the witches foretold actually did come true. But Macbeth blocks the conversation short with his cunning act by saying,
I think not of them.
Macbeth then tells Banquo that they shall speak in further detail of a proposition Macbeth has for Banquo. He says that this idea can be talked about later on, and that it will benefit Banquo in some way. Banquo says that he'll do whatever Macbeth has in mind, so long as it is not morally wrong to do so. And as Banquo and Fleance leaves, Macbeth commands his servant to tell Lady Macbeth to ring the bell when his drink is ready. All alone, Macbeth is left to his thoughts. Suddenly, he sees an illusion in front of him. A dagger, floating in the air, with its handle so readily pointed towards him, and the tip of the dagger pointing towards the direction where Duncan is fast asleep. But when Macbeth tries to reach out to grab the dagger, he simply cannot seem to do so. Macbeth realizes that the dagger was just an illusion, and towards the end of his thoughts, we can see that he just wants to get through with the killing as soon as possible. He feels that while he continues to merely mutter things to himself, on and on about Duncan's death, Duncan himself isn't in any way more dead than before. He says the longer he waits, the more he finds himself to be less motivated to kill Duncan, as time has a way of cooling off his courage and his ambition. And right at that moment, Lady Macbeth rings the bell. This is Macbeth's cue. The bell serves as a call from Lady Macbeth to Macbeth, saying that the next steps to the killing is ready to take place. The king's men are asleep, and now Macbeth must head off to finally commit the crime that he has been contemplating over and over again.
I go, and it is done. The bell invites me. Hear it not, Duncan, for it is a knell that summons thee to heaven or to hell.